ग्राउंड वाटर सर्व्स टू द ओनली ड्रिंकिंग वाटर रिसोर्सेस इन मेनी पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ग्लोबली अबाउट 2.5 बिलियन पीपल आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन ग्राउंड वाटर फॉर देयर ड्रिंकिंग इरिगेशन एंड इंडस्ट्रियल पर्पसेस In only India, 75% people rely on groundwater, and 95% of the water used for irrigation purposes. Therefore, it is most important to know the quality of the groundwater or surface water for various purposes. In this context, hydrogeochemistry of to know the hydrogeochemistry of the groundwater is most important. Suppose if you find out the toxic elements in the groundwater, when we apply the human health risk assessment, by human health risk assessment, it will give you a overview of the contamination process, and it will lead to the human health risk, and then we can measure the mitigation methods that will really helpful to the all people. So in this presentation, I am going to cover the few points that will really helpful to you, helpful to the new researchers. And here I am not going to give detailed information, but those who are doing some basic research scientists and in various organizations, that will this presentation will be helpful for them in order to implement their research program in various organizations. In this presentation, I am going to give a overview of these things. And in this presentation, I am going to give a overview of these following points: how to choose the study region, and how to collect the groundwater samples, and what kind of safety measures should we take while collecting the samples. Analysis procedure, interpretation of the physicochemical parameters, how to calculate the human health risk assessment, how to choose the study area. Suppose if you ask me some question, is there any scientific method to choose the study area? And in my opinion, I can say that it is totally depend on candidate interest, and then only we can do something. And in addition to that, here I am provide some information which will be helpful to you to choose a appropriate study area to conduct a research hydrogeochemical study in any region. Generally, Central Groundwater Board and State Groundwater Board publishes groundwater reports every year. And are once in a 6 months. Then please, in addition to that, Indian Meteorological Department also publishes reports monthly basis or yearly basis. Please collect the some 2 to 3 years data and please go through that. For example, I stay in Telangana state. I want to conduct a research program in this Telangana state. I need to collect the Telangana state groundwater board details from the Central Groundwater Board and State Groundwater Board. And in addition to that, Meteorological Department, in this Meteorological Department publishes rainwater information, temperature, and precipitation information. And initially, we find out the higher concentration and lower concentration in particular region. Suppose in Telangana, it is most of the area covered by hard rock terrain. And most of the researchers report for the fluoride concentration. So I need to collect, suppose I want to conduct a research program on the topic of fluoride and its contamination. Then I can choose for where is the high fluoride concentration in their reports. Then it will, suppose if I find out a Nalgonda district, and these reports generally Central Groundwater Board and State Groundwater Board do the research on recognition survey. They may not collect vast number of samples in a single region. They may cover entire state, and therefore we can choose one particular region. And suppose a researcher can find out some region it is approximately 100 square kilometer to 600 kilometer based on the availability of funding. Therefore, it will really helpful to you to choose that particular region. Then only we can do some research programs. Once we select the study region, then we can go for topo sheets. Topo sheet. General Geological Survey of India publishes topo sheets. It contains largest scale and small scale. What is the largest scale? Largest scale means 1:10,000 10,000 scale. It means 1 centimeter on the ground. It represents to the 100 meters on the 1 centimeter on the topo sheet. It represents to the 100 centimeter on the ground. What is the smallest scale? 1:250,000 scale. This is the largest scale. It really represents to the 1 centimeter on the map equal to the 2.5 kilometers on the ground. So as a researcher, as a basic researcher, and we may go for topo sheets. We may select the topo sheet 1:25,000 topo sheet or 1:10,000 topo sheet. Then only we can do some research on that particular region. In addition to that, Survey of India publishes geological maps. Survey of India publishes geological maps. Then in that maps we can do several information in order to know about our study region. But in generally, location map, once we find out the location, in addition to that, we can collect the climate information from the meteorological department. In topo sheet also, we can find out some drainage pattern and in the study region. Topography and geology of the study region. Topography is outcrops of the appearance of the outcrops. Hydrological conditions, precipitation information you can gather from the Indian Meteorological Department. Here I am providing some topo sheet. This topo sheet was published in Survey of India. It topo sheet represents number is E44G16. Scale is 1:50,000. It means 1 centimeter on the topo sheet equal to the 50,000 centimeters on the ground. It is equal to the 0.5 kilometer on the ground. In this topo sheet, we can find out some information that will really helpful to the to conduct our research. Here, red color indicates the village map, village, and this is green color indicates the reserve forest. And white color also indicates about the outcrops of the study region. These white lines, the red lines indicates the main roads of the study region. And these are the, we can find out some drainage pattern. First stream, first order drainage pattern, second order drainage pattern, and it counts to the reach to the pond area. Then we can, once we find out this location, we can choose, suppose I want to conduct a research program in this box. It is Chinnakodu region in Medak district. Then we can choose this area, study region, and using by GIS or Surfer soft. If you're familiar with GIS or Surfer, please go to that software, digitize it before going to the sample. In the topo sheet, we can there is a index map beside the left side of the left this corner. We can find out the total information about the what is the color indication. This is indication about the outcrops of the rocks and water bodies and rock filled water regions and drainage with track beds and undefined canals. And this is the sub features of the rocky slopes. And with information, this red color indicates the villages or towns. And more features also available with the in this program, in this topo sheet, we can find out all features what we need in this collect. We need to collect so many information by using the GIS, by using Survey of India topo sheets and geological map of the study region. For example, this study was done by Subba Rao and he used this topography information, and he generated by using GIS software, and he generated this is the study region about this. This study was not done by me, another researcher, and he generated this topo sheet. In this diagram, he explains about the entire study region is occupied by the granite rocks, and this is the drainage pattern, groundwater level, topographical evolution, and this round figure indicates the sample numbers. This is another study. This is not done by me. This is one of the Chinese supervisor done this study area. In this diagram, he explains about the most of the information he explained in the topo in the location map of the study region. This red color dot indicates the sampling location. Arrow mark indicates the direction of the groundwater flow and sampling points. And lines indicates the groundwater level. This is the yellow river and habitations and paddy field. And one, this is the, there is no criteria how to generate the location map of the study area. It is totally depending on candidate researcher interest. For example, we can see another location map. This is the another study region. This is not done by me. I collected this information in the published data. He uses this, he generated location map of the study area by using GIS software. In this diagram, he explained about the only, he drawn only drainage pattern of the study region and sampling location. It was published in Environmental Earth Sciences. That is the candidate. What I am trying to give some information, that is the total interest regarding to the candidate's interest. There is no guidelines to generate for the, we can generate in such a way. There is no such guidelines, but it is totally interest to the researcher. Once we find out the location map of the study region and location map of the sample, location map of the study region, and we collect the topo sheet and geological map of the study region, then we are ready to field. And as per American Public Health Organization, high density polyethylene bottles are suggested to are recommended for drinking water samples. For collecting the samples. In addition to the water bottles, we need to take some basic information, field notebook, camera, and GPS, and portable PHEC TDS meter. With this only, we can do some, we can go for field work to collect the water samples. And what kind of measures, safety measures should we take while collecting the samples? And American Public Health Organization has given so many recommendations. How do we analyze this? How do we collect the samples by using our methods? As per once we are reached in the field, it is better to clean the water high density polyethylene bottles in the laboratory, clean the water bottles in the laboratory, and once we reach that place, we also clean by using the collected water samples. And all samples are to be filtered, and cation samples were acidified using nitric acid 0.5 ml per 100 millimeter of water, and to avoid possible concentration changes. And all collected water samples should be kept in below recommended temperature. In addition to collecting the samples, we need to record the latitude, longitude of the sampling location, elevation, landmark, depth of the borewell. And please ensure that we do not collect the stagnant water. And suppose if you choose a borewell, we do not collect the stagnant water. and therefore we must pour out, we must pump out the stagnant water for 10 to 15 minutes to remove the stagnant water. Then only we can fill the water, we can fill the water samples and store and give the appropriate number and with latitude, longitude and elevation. It is better to record landmark also, and we can take a picture from this location whether it is a borewell or dug well or hand pump. And the temperature pH EC how to become measured in the field, because traveling time it reaches temperature, electrical conductivity changes once we reach the laboratory. It is better to measure pH EC by using portable pH EC meters in the field itself. Here I am providing some basic analysis procedure. In Usman University, we do not have sophisticated laboratories. Therefore, we analyzed samples by using wet chemical laboratory. In this laboratory, I did analysis by using this method so far. And pH EC assessed in the field itself by using portable pH EC meter. And TDS, Anna has recommended that electrical conductivity into 0.55 to 0.75. Then we collect when we multiply it EC, then we can get the TDS concentration. And TA and TA volumetric method. calcium is a volumetric method, and sodium potassium by using flame photometry method, and fluoride nitrate advanced method, and ion selective electrode method. We can easily assess the ion fluoride and nitrate by using ion selective electrode method. In that, if we analyze the fluoride by using ion selective electrode, we can add TISA, total ionic strength. It is mostly we can add 0.5 ml of the TISA in the 100 ml of samples. Once we do the analysis in a wet chemical laboratory, it is most important to the whether our analysis is accurate or not. And once we do some analysis in the laboratory, we may do some mistakes. Therefore, the accuracy of the analysis may get wrong. So for this reason, ion balance error percentage is to assess the ion selective ion balance error is most important. In this calculation, we can do total concentration and total concentration of the cations, total concentration of the anions by total concentration plus total anions into 100. Once we incorporate all these cations and anions in this formula, all cations and anions should be in milliequivalent per liter, and as per suggested by the recommended methods, this IBE ionic balance error percentage should be plus or minus 10%. Once we get the analysis report below the 10 plus or minus 10%, then we can assure that this our analysis is accurate. Then only we can go for further analysis. Here I am giving conversion factor of the milli equivalent per liter. Generally, our analysis records in the milligrams per liter. This chart book gives I take this chart from the TARD, and there is a conversion factor. For example, calcium conversion factor is equal to 0.04990. Suppose in our study region, we can get an 100 mg per liter what is the conversion factor? 0.99 milliequivalent per liter. That is equivalent to the 4.99 milliequivalent per liter. In addition to the, we can use this chart and we can generate, we can convert our milligrams per liter data into milliequivalent per liter. Once we complete the analysis procedure in that program, then we can interpretation is most important. Groundwater or surface water is mostly used for drinking and irrigation industrial purpose. Therefore, quality criteria depends on the usage of for particular purpose. And it suppose here I am providing some details about the upper limits of the World Health Organization, Bureau of Indian Standards, United States Environmental Protection Agency, European Union. Suppose we live in Indian continent, it is better to use Bureau of Indian Standards limits for our physicochemical parameters. Here I am providing some upper limits of the parameters. There is a difference between World Health Organization and Bureau of Indian Standards. For example, here I am showing nitrate. World Health Organization permits 50 mg per liter, but Indian circumstances it is 45 milligrams per liter only. Therefore, it is better to use, in my opinion, it is better to use Bureau of Indian Standards in order to assess the water quality for drinking purpose in India. Hydrogen ion concentration. It is most important to this is the most important parameter. As per no health risk was found when we drink alkalinity water and acidic water. Generally, in a solution, hydrogen ion concentration and hydroxyl ion concentration is equal, then it pH is 7. And if below 7 is indicates the acidic nature of the water, and above 7 indicates the alkaline nature of the water. If what is the main mechanism in this pH is equal to the below 7 is indicate the increase of the H plus ion concentration in the water, decrease of the hydroxyl ion OH minus ion concentration decreases in when acidic nature of the water. In addition, if the pH water is above 7 indicates the alkalinity, and it decreases the hydrogen H plus ion concentration decreasing, and simultaneously OH minus hydroxyl ion concentration increases in this pH. And so far there is, as I discussed earlier, there is no direct effect on human health, but it shows a good relationship with other chemicals. Electrical conductivity is a measure of the ability to conduct current to the higher concentration designates the enrichment of salts in the groundwater. And Subbarao 2012 recommends the classified the EC based on electrical conductivity concentration. According to him, he classified electrical conductivity into three different types: type 1, type 2, type 3. If the type 1 is below 15, if we find out electrical conductivity below 15 microsiemens per liter, it indicates the enrichment salts are very low. And what is the type 2? Type 2 is electrical conductivity 1500 to 3000. In between 1500 to 3000, it comes under the type 3. It indicates that electrical conductivity enrichment of salts are medium. And what about the type 3? Type 3 are above milliequivalent, above 3000 microsiemens per centimeter. As per, there is no guidelines for the electrical conductivity. And HEM 1985 stated that ionic concentration of the groundwater groundwater sample is generally evaluated by measuring EC, which varies according to the temperature, concentration, and type of ion present in it. See, when we measure the temperature, generally we measure the room temperature. The instrument should be arranged at 25 degrees centigrade. Then the EC will be accurate. EC will be accurate because it based on temperature the EC concentration may increase or decrease. Therefore, it is better to assess the EC at 25 degrees centigrade. Here I am providing some information. This study was done by me in 2019, and I took as it is in my published data. I classified EC based on Subbarao 2012. And we can classify the analysis data according to this classification. 91% of samples fall under the type 1 enrichment of salts are low, and only 8% of the samples have been shown to be type 2. And higher concentration of depends on the weathering of aquifer materials and the influence of the anthropogenic activity polluting the groundwater. Eventually, large alteration in EC concentration are due to the geochemical process like rainfall and infiltration, evaporation, ion exchange phenomena. Suppose once we interpret the data, it is most important to show the pictorial form of distribution map of all physicochemical parameters or heavy metals or trace metal. Here I am showing this diagram not generated by me, but I taken from the published data. And this author has explained, the author has given a different classified into different types. You see, green color indicates the below 500 EC is shown in green color. And 500 to 750 is concentration of EC is shown in yellow color. Above 750 microsiemens per centigrade, microsiemens per centimeter is shown in red color. And there is a word, 100, one picture shows, one picture is greater than the 100 words. This picture is clearly explains about the electrical conductivity concentration in different parts of this location. Total dissolved solids, and in addition to the World Health Organization and another two researchers have classified total dissolved solids in for different purposes. As per the World Health Organization, and if we find out below 300, it is excellent for drinking purpose, and 300 to 600 it good for drinking purpose, and 600 to 900 fair quality, and if it is increases, if it is more than 1200, unacceptable for drinking and irrigation according to World Health Organization. But Davis, he has given a fourfold classification. If we find below 500 TDS concentration, that is most useful for drinking purpose. 500 to 1000 is permissible for drinking purpose. And if 100 to 1000 to 300 is also useful for irrigation purposes. More than 3000 is unfit for drinking and irrigation purpose. Similarly, Freeze and Cherry 1979 is classified in different way because different way. Suppose when we interpret our data, on what purpose we are interpreting, and whether it is drinking purpose or irrigation purpose, industrial purpose, based on that we can choose appropriate classification in order to explain the TDS in our study. This is the distribution of the TDS. This study was done by me. This map is explains about the three categories. below 500 is shown in blue color, and yellow color indicates the below 1500, 500 to 1500 is shown in blue color, and red color is more than 1500. And most of the region is under the 500 to 1500 concentration of TDS. This is another study. I took this map from the published article. This study classified pre-monsoon and post-monsoon. See, based on your available data, if you collect two seasons, you can generate two distribution maps of the particular ion, particular chemical element. You can generate the distribution map of the variant. Then only you can know where is the higher concentration and whether it is pre-monsoon concentration is high or the post-monsoon concentration is high. In this study, if we generally see the green color is increasing, blue color is increasing, and simultaneously green color also is increasing, and then distribution of the same, but pre-post-monsoon the concentration is higher than the pre-monsoon. Total dissolved solids, and normally the occurrence of calcium magnesium ions refer to the hardness. Hardness is very important for property for water for domestical application point of view. Similarly, hard water causes problem in boiler industries. Acceptable limit is 200 milligrams per liter, which can be extended up to 600 mg per liter in case of non-availability of any alternate water source. This WHO was recommended limit is, highest recommended limit is 600, maximum permissible limit is 600 according to the World Health Organization. And Cherry has Swayer and 1967, he has classified a different way. He has classified fourfold classification based on the total hardness. According to him, soft water, moderate water, hard water, very hard water. And the range is here. If we find if our sample is below 75, that indicates the soft water category. If we find out our total concentration, total hardness in our study, 75 to 150 moderately hard. And if we find our total hardness more than 300, it comes under very hard category. This is the distribution of the total hardness in that particular region, and he has classified based on the Swayer 1967. Therefore, he is shown in green color indicates the below 775, and yellow color indicates the moderate hard category of the water sample. 55 more than 150 total hardness concentration indicates the hard type of the water. Bicarbonate. And bicarbonate is the major anion in the freshwater body. The source of bicarbonate ion in the groundwater is atmosphere CO2, which dissolves in water to form carbonic acid. Reaction of carbonic acid with limestone contamination containing minerals like albite, and from partial of the complete decomposition of organic matter, which helps to raise the bicarbonate concentration in the groundwater. And it is most important, so far there is no desirable and permissible limits for the bicarbonate concentration, but however we can use some existing data explain the bicarbonate concentration in that particular study. And this is another distribution map of the study, and he classified only two fold classification, and in this study he used below 250 and above 250. And in this diagram it is shown that number of samples and two variants. And chloride may be derived from another parameter, chloride. Chloride may be derived from the pollution source, such as effluents of the industrial and domestic waste, leakage of septic tanks, from the nature and sources such as rainfall and dissolution of chloride bearing minerals. The concentration of chloride in groundwater relatively due to the evaporation enriched and irrigation returns flow and to related to the water rock interaction. The permissible limit of the chloride for drinking water is 250 milligrams per liter according to the WHO. In case chloride concentration in water is usually take an index of pollution and considered to tracer for groundwater and containing contamination high concentration of chloride in drinking water cause salty taste and have a laxative effect too. This is another distribution of the chloride concentration, and in this he generated this diagram by using Surfer software. He classified in different way, and blue color indicates the lowest concentration of the study region, and red color indicates the highest concentration on the particular region. And most of the higher concentration is recorded in northeastern part of the region. Nitrate, generally in pure water nitrate concentration is seldom present. However, in natural condition nitrate does not exceed 10 mg per liter. Thus, if it is higher than the 10 mg per liter, we can understand that this is contaminated by the man-made pollution. And this particularly nitrate concentration increases by region to region, mainly poor sanitary conditions, indiscriminate usage of higher fertilizers, and for crop field are responsible for more concentration of nitrate in groundwater. And nitrate fertilizers also in India, if you see 1951 to 2016, more than 200 times of usage of nitrate is using in India. Therefore, nitrate concentration is increasing day by day, year by year. This was reported in the National Center for Integrated Pest Management in the study in India. Therefore, in the Indian ground, in most of the agriculture area, nitrate concentration is increasing because of the high usage of nitrate fertilizers. As per the WHO, 50 mg per liter is maximum permissible limit. But according to the Bureau of Indian Standards, 45 mg per liter. Suppose excessive intake of nitrate causes some health risks, such as health risk is blue baby syndrome. In particular, blue baby syndrome. In addition to that, Foreman ET 1985 reported that enlargement of thyroid and 15 types of cancer, and two kids of birth defects, and even hypertension among people who consume drinking water containing nitrates. In the sense of increasing rates of stomach cancer with increasing nitrate intake. Therefore, it is better to estimate the nitrate concentration in that chosen study region, and also if we find out higher concentration of nitrate in that particular region, we should take mitigation methods in order to reduce the nitrate concentration. This is another study not done by me. I have taken this map from the published data, and here the author is explained, classified the nitrate concentration in different way, and blue color indicates the below 15 mg per liter, and red color indicates the above 81 to 96 mg per liter. But once we go, suppose if we want to generate a nitrate distribution map, it is better to classify the according to the World Health Organization or Bureau of Indian Standards. Here I am showing distribution frequency distribution map of nitrate in the groundwater samples in the study region. This study one done by me this data is available ecotoxic. This this article is published in Ecotoxicology and Environmental Safety. In this in that paper, I used in Bureau of Indian Standards Limits and World Health Organization. I generated this diagram in order to explain the distribution of nitrate in that in the study region. So in this diagram clearly explains the 73.52% of water sample below the drinking water Bureau of Indian Standard limits, and in addition to that 26.4% of the percent of water samples is above the maximum permissible limit to 50 mg per liter in the study region. This is totally you can generate based on your idea how to interpret your study. Fluoride, it is well known that in India and most of the other regions have higher fluoride concentration due to various reasons. For example, and water rock interaction, and fluoride is a highly electronegativity ion. Fluoride is a interacts with other chemical elements, and it is a negative ionic charge, and it therefore it releases into the water by various process. And for example in hard rock terrain, fluoride, biotite, muscovite, spiny are the fluoride examples of the fluoride bearing minerals. In general, granite rock contains fluoride concentration 22,300 milligrams per liter. Apatite, amphibole, pegmatite, hornblende, muscovite, biotite, spiny are the examples of fluorine bearing minerals. Here, this NIAC and WHO classified the fluoride concentration in drinking water. And in this, according to him, he classified the classified in different way. Below 0.5 dental it damages to the dental caries, and 0.5 to 1.5 milligrams per liter promotes the dental health. And 1.5 to 4 mg per liter dental fluoride is generates the dental fluorosis and mantling teeth. And about 4 to 10 is skeletal fluorosis, and more than 10 crippling fluorosis. I have published one article in entire Telangana state as a review article. It was published in Geochemistry Journal. In this, I collected published data and described the source of the fluoride concentration and mitigation methods, and where is the higher concentration in that Telangana state. This map clearly shows the northern southern part of the study region have recorded higher concentration of the fluoride, and this is the Nalgonda state where most of the research done on fluoride concentration, and it is so far it has reported more than 10 mg per liter in this particular region. But based on our convenient, as per the NIAC classification, I have done, I did this classification based on the NIAC, and this generated this distribution map of the study region by using Surfer software. And this 0. Green color indicates the, this is the green color indicates the water is suitable for drinking and irrigation drinking purpose, and yellow color is the not suitable for drinking, and red color indicates the not suitable for drinking because the higher concentration is found in that particular region. And what is the major mechanism of the fluoride in that particular water? Generally, fluoride interacts the fluoride generally fluorine bearing fluoride exchange the by OH hydroxyl ions, because it ionic radii is similar. For example, muscovite, if you take muscovite and it muscovite and it, it when it interacts with the hydroxyl ions and releases to the fluoride. In similar way, fluoroapatite and weathering fluoroapatite, when it interacts with the hydroxyl ions means alkaline nature of the water. Alkaline, what as we discussed earlier, what is the alkaline nature of water? Decreases the H plus ions, increases the OH minus ions. Therefore, alkaline nature of the water also enhance, there is a chance to enhance the fluoride concentration in some regions. Biotite, when it interacts to the hydroxyl ions, it releases to the fluoride. Suppose sodium bicarbonate water type, when it interacts with the sodium bicarbonate water type, also leads to the fluoride concentration in the water. If we find out higher bicarbonate and alkaline nature of the water, also helpful to the release of fluoride in the water. And these are the major sources of the major ions and minor ions and trace elements, and this is the major sources and I have taken this in one published book, and this will really helpful to you why it is high and what is the major reason. For example, as we discussed in previous slide, fluoride concentration, if we find out in our study region fluoride concentration high because of fluorine bearing minerals and fluorite and biotite, and in addition to that we can also note that is there an additional contamination process in our study region, and based on our interest we can find out some other regions also. Mechanism, so far we have discussed the physicochemical parameters and distribution, and when comparing to the Bureau of Indian Standards and World Health Organization. In addition to that, here we can discuss about the mechanism controlling groundwater chemistry. This Gibbs diagram, Gibbs proposed one potential diagram in order to know the mechanism that are involved in the water. Generally, Gibbs diagram explains about the precipitation, rock water interaction, evaporation, and in this diagram we can know how our water interacts to the whether evaporation or precipitation or rock water interaction. In this diagram, this is a Gibbs diagram. Gibbs diagram equal proportion to the chloride and bicarbonate in the proportion to the total dissolved solids. That is the anion diagram. This is the cation diagram. Sodium and calcium proportion to the total dissolved solids. And 1000 to 10,000 is considered as a rock water interaction. When our samples fall in this category, in this region, it clearly explains about the rock water interaction. Based on this diagram, we can estimate that our study region water inclines to the rock water interaction to the evaporation zone. Piper diagram, and Piper diagram is useful for evaluating the geochemical evolution of the groundwater in any region. The map is useful for if we have large number of samples of chemical analysis can be compiled into Piper Tallina diagram, and this can helpful us to classify the data in different variations. As Purple K. Sahu explained about the Piper classification based on by using useful software. and here I am trying to give some other information in order to understand the classification of the Piper and other software. The Piper diagram contains two triangular charts for depicting the proportion of cations and anions expressed in milliequivalent per liter. And the triangulars for cations has 100% calcium, it is in the left corner, and 100% of sodium and potassium towards right corner, right, and 100% of magnesium towards upward. Similarly, triangle for anions has 100% of chloride in the right corner and 100% of carbonates in the towards right, and 100% of sulfate towards up. This is the one of the similar diagram of Piper. This diagram clearly explains about the water type and what is the major domination ions. If we take example, this diagram as a cation triangular, this is anion triangular. In this diagram, if we 0 to 100 increases to the cation concentration. If we find out, A indicates the calcium dominant ion in this. But here is only few sample fall in that area, but increasing towards B and C. What is B? Did the magnesium concentration increases from 0 to 100, from here to there. In addition to that, sodium and potassium from top to bottom increases. This triangular diagram clearly explains in this particular study region, the magnesium concentration and sodium type of water, sodium cations is dominating in the study region. In addition to that, in the middle triangular diagram, it is called no dominant cations are is higher than the magnesium and sodium concentration. Similarly, we can explain about the anions triangular by using this anions triangular. In this diagram, there is no chloride, there is no sulfate concentration, there is no domination of sulfate concentration in this in the particular region, but it is increasing towards towards bicarbonate concentration. Carbonate and bicarbonate are increasing in the study region. These two diagrams, cations triangular and anions triangular, represents to the diamond shaped field. This diamond shaped field classified into five categories. This you can see in we can also find out this information in the Todd book, and it explains clearly. And in this we can also classify based on the manual based on methods. In this diamond shaped, I classified based on six categories. In one is indicates the calcium and bicarbonate type of the the geochemical phases, and two, these two is indicate the sodium and chloride type of the phases, and three is the indicates the mixed calcium sodium bicarbonate phases. And similarly, we can generate by using Todd explanation. Todd has given some information about the classification of the diamond shaped field. Based on according to him, ninefold classification were given in that particular in that Piper triangular diagram. So this is the ninefold classification, and this is the diamond shaped is classified into the 1 and 2. Another one is 3 and 4. In this diagram, we can see major 1 to 9 classifications were given classified in the Todd book, and it is helpful to the describe of our study region. our study region concentration of hydrogeochemical phases and domination of cations and anions. Here I would like to give some information about the how to generate the pipetinal diagram free software. USGS GOAT has given some free website, then we can download. Once we, this is the website link, and we can, if we click the download, if we click and we can generate, we can download the software. The icon of the software shows like this GW underscore chart. Once we click, once we downloading process completed, then icon will appear in our desktop or some other place. And once we click this Piper diagram, groundwater chart software, and it appears like this. The first phase of the software appears like this. In this, there is no more information in this software, but it is most, it is useful for classifying. It is useful for generating the Piper diagram, Piper trilinear diagram by using simple software. Once we click the chart type and convert, and we can find out the Piper trilinear diagram. Then click the chart type and select the Piper trilinear diagram. Once we select the Piper trilinear diagram, and it appears like this. This is the fixed program: calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium, bicarbonate, carbonate and bicarbonate, chloride, sulfate, TDS. We should not say change this pattern. It is auto inbuilt. This is the inbuilt. This ion concentration inbuilted in the software. Then it appears like this. Please put your cursor in the blue box, and your data should be placed. Your data analysis physicochemical parameters data should be arranged according to this format in the Excel sheet, and select the entire analysis, whether it is 100 samples or 1500 samples, 1500 samples, 500 samples or 10 samples. You can select the all samples, put your cursor here and click the paste. Don't pay, if we click paste, we may not, we cannot do, the analysis data does not paste by clicking right hand and paste. But here is the software inputs, paste is here. Once we put one, keep your cursor in the blue, cursor in the blue box and paste here, click the paste, it will, here I am giving some example, I pasted the analysis data by clicking this paste button. And this is all the in this particular region example I am giving, in this all this analysis samples are shown in this particular region in this our study. And there are the symbols. There are another symbols, as we purple case of explain it, different symbols and different parameter, different symbols according to your choice. There is a circle shape and triangular shape and square shape and rectangular shapes also available. Different shapes are also available in this free software. And click this symbol circle and choose the appropriate to symbol according to your data. Suppose your data is your constant, if you analyzed pre-monsoon, post-monsoon, you can describe, you can discriminate, you can classify the analysis data into two different symbols. And you can also change the color by clicking this color option. And once we complete this basic manual method, when here is the data and click plot, once we click the plot, there is a symbol, there is a plot button. Once we click this button, it appears like this. It appears like this. And I forgot to tell something, but your analysis data is generally we analyze the all physicochemical parameters in the milligrams per liter. These softwares have some options, milli equivalent per liter and milligrams per liter. Suppose if you choose the milligrams per liter analysis data in your region, and you can choose this, you can click the milligrams per liter. Suppose if you if you convert the your physicochemical parameters data into milli equivalent per liter, you can click this milli equivalent per data, milli equivalent per liter option. So I converted this data into milli equivalent per liter, and I click this option and pasted here, and it appears like this. Once we click the plot, and it appears like this. Here there is some basic settings. There we cannot see some basic settings here. We should so there is how to increase the concentration 0 to 100. There is no 100 marks, and here magnesium concentration increases from here to here. There is no sodium and sodium and potassium concentration here 0 to 100. There is no symbols. For that, we can go to the settings. Here is the option is available, settings. Then once we click the settings, once we click this setting button, and it appears like this. And please select the grid options. There is a grid option here, and you can choose 5, 10, 20, 50, 25, 50% and based on according to your plan, you can choose your Piper Diamond diagram by clicking the cursor here. So here I click the option, here I choose the option 50% of the 50%. Then once we click the option OK, it appears like this, and it is the 50%, 0 to it, once we count this, here is the 0, here is 100, and it is inbuilt, there is another triangular. And in addition to that, here we forgot to the numbering system. Again, you can go to the setting options, click the show numbers. There is a square box. If you click this, if you choose this option, show the numbers, it automatically appears in the diagram. In this plot, I did not choose the numbering system. That's why I got this diagram. And once we click this here, this diagram shows a full length of Piper Tylenol diagram. But this software is a default. This is the default program. We cannot find out the hydrogeochemical phases, but we can, as we discussed earlier, we can also choose the by classifying this classifying ninefold classification, and based on that Todd book, it has given clear classification in the Todd book. Based on that, we can classify our study. Then once we finalize the data, and here is the file option, click that file and save in appropriate way, JPEG or some other format. According to your plan, you can save your Piper Tylenol diagram in that particular region. And in addition to that, once we export the map, another ninefold classification will be given by using Grapher software. JPG formats, please export to your imports to this Piper diagram into the Grapher software, and there you can classify ninefold classification according to the Todd book, and you can define your description here, and you can also describe your here, and according to our plan, you can do by using Grapher software, some other softwares. So far we have discussed the physicochemical parameters for drinking parameters, and it is useful comparing to the World Health Organization and Bureau of Indian Standards. So I tried my best to explain the Piper Tylenol classification by using simple software which is freely available for everyone. and whether it is our water is suitable or not suitable for drinking water classification. Here I am giving some additional information in order to know the water for groundwater or surface water, whether it is useful for drinking and irrigation purpose. There are so many parameters that are available in the literature. For example, sodium absorption ratio, percent of sodium, Killy ratio or Killy index or Killy ratio. Some researchers have given some KR means Killy ratio, and some researchers are indicating that Killy index, residual sodium carbonate, magnesium absorption ratio. In addition to that, some other parameters, PI and Wilcox diagram and USSLDA diagram. Based on your choice, you can choose according to your plan. But here I am giving some basic information about the sodium absorption ratio by using basic parameters. Sodium absorption ratio, percent of sodium, Killy ratio, residual sodium carbonate and magnesium absorption ratio. Here sodium absorption ratio is directly related to the sodium absorbed by soil, and it measures to the relative proportion of sodium in water and calcium and magnesium ions. And high level of SAR in water enriches the soil alkalinity and reduces the soil permeability along the water sample availability of plants. And if we increase the SAR, that literally harmful to the irrigation purpose. Then we can take the sodium, calcium, magnesium concentration in the milli equivalent per liter, and we can input this equation, we can get some concentration. As per the SAR classification, it has given fourfold classification. If we find out below 10, excellent for drinking water. If you find out our data 10 to 18, good for irrigation. Or if you find out 18 to 26, permissible for drinking, and 26, if you find out 26, unsuitable for drinking purpose. And please note that when we use these parameters, sodium absorption ratio, percent of sodium, Killy ratio, and residual bicarbonate and magnesium absorption ratio, all parameters should be expressed in milli equivalent per liter. And percentage of sodium, this is the equation which will be used to calculate the percentage of sodium. And sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sodium and potassium, all parameters should be converted into milli equivalent per liter. And it is most important parameter that will enable us to know whether the water is suitable for drinking, what the water is suitable for irrigation or not. As per Wilcox 1955, he classified the sodium percentage in different ways, and according to him, below 20 mg per liter, below 20 sodium percentage, if you get, that is a excellent for irrigation purpose, and 20 to 40 good for the irrigation, and 40 to 60 and permissible for drinking. In addition to that, if you find out in your region 60 to 80 and more than 80, it is approximately unsuitable for drinking purpose. So this simple classification will enable us to know whether the water is suitable or for irrigation purpose. And Killy index. Please note that some researchers describe this Killy index in Killy ratio. Killy ratio or Killy index are similar, but the equation are similar in order to assess the Killy ratio. Why Killy means Killy has described, Killy has defined this equation and found invented this equation in order to assess the water for irrigation purpose. Therefore, Killy, some people may call it Killy ratio, or some people may call in Killy index. However, and Killy found this, invented this equation, KR or KI equal to sodium percentage by calcium and magnesium. Generally, if we find out more than one, it does not suitable for the irrigation purpose. If we find out the water samples, our water and KR ratio is less than one, and that is suitable for the irrigation purpose. And in addition to that, magnesium absorption ratio and residual sodium carbonate is also another parameter, so that are also useful for in order to assess the water for irrigation purpose. As per the magnesium absorption ratio, this is the one of the hydrogeological indices suggested by the author and has been used for assessing the water quality for irrigation uses. Commonly in the water sample, magnesium and so calcium keeps up the condition of equilibrium. However, depleting the low level of promotes saltiness of the water, and along these lines decreases the crop production. Therefore, it is most important to assess the magnesium absorption ratio, or some people may call it magnesium hazard. So whether you call it magnesium absorption ratio or magnesium hazard, that both the equation is same for both of magnesium absorption ratio or magnesium hazard. Please input your data in this equation, and if you get more than 50%, if you get more than 50, it is unsuitable for drinking. And if you get your data MAR ratio is below 50, that also indicates that suitable for drinking purpose. And residual sodium bicarbonate is a relation alkaline earths with the weak acids. Alkaline earths means calcium and magnesium. Weak acids means carbonate. That is, we know all about the weak acids and alkaline earths, and expressed in terms of residual sodium carbonate for assessing the quality of water for irrigation purpose. When the weak acids greater than the alkaline earths, precipitation of alkaline earths occurs in soil. That dramatically damages the soil permeability. Therefore, we cannot get the productivity of crops. Therefore, it is most important to assess the residual sodium bicarbonate by using this formula. And if we input our data in this equation, then if we get generally RS residual sodium bicarbonate, we may not get more than 10 RSC values. And I have seen so many articles in this residual sodium bicarbonate. As per my understanding, no paper was published in more than 10 or 15 RSC value. That clearly indicates that that clearly shows if you find out more than 20 RSC value, please recheck your analysis data, whether you have done analysis properly or not. As per this classification, if you find 1.25 RSC value, it is good for irrigation purpose, and 1.25 to 2.50 is doubtful for irrigation, and 2.5 to above more than 2.5 unsuitable for irrigation. In addition to that, Wilcox diagram, USSL diagram also helpful to the description of the water for in irrigation purpose. But in this presentation, I am not giving that detailed diagram information, but this is the basic understanding of the basic understanding of the what are parameters that are useful for assessing, evaluating the irrigation purpose. So far we have discussed physicochemical parameters, whether it is useful for drinking and irrigation purpose. Suppose and if we find out toxic elements, for example sodium toxic elements, fluoride, nitrate, arsenic, and in most of the Telangana region we found that fluoride and nitrate concentration is higher and arsenic is very low. So I implemented this health risk assessment by using so fluoride and nitrate concentration. This health risk assessment is invented by the United States Environmental Protection Agency in several years ago, and it is a fourfold classification. And in each classification, we need to know each classification: hazard identification and dose response assessment, exposure assessment, and risk categorization. And so far this diagram is generated. This is the pictorial form of health risk assessment method, and this data you can find out my publications which was published in Human Ecological Risk Assessment Journal. And once we find out the higher concentration, when we implement this health risk assessment, if we find out higher concentration of the toxic elements, then only we can implement the health risk assessment. That will really enable us to know what is the future consequence. If we intake the higher concentration of the toxic elements water through water and through drinking purpose. And in this according to US EPA, in United States Environmental Protection Agency, as people were considered in this category, people were taken female, male, and children and infants also. But it is better to choose, because why it is classified in three different categories, because every male female body weight is different, and consumption of water is also different, and exposure of the water and is also different. Therefore, then you may please go to the website US EPA, find out some useful information, more information why he classified different adults and children and infants. That really really enables us to when we implement the health risk assessment in our study region. And if we in addition to that, oral intake and dermal contact. Generally, water is most of the we take huge amount of water will take by intake of drinking water. Dermal contact, when we touch the water in our body, that is considered as a dermal contact. There is no another part here. I did not input, because inhalation part, because water is therefore that in when we come to the water, and it is better to use for it is better to use the implement the health risk assessment by using oral intake and dermal contact only. Drinking water pathway is a another way we can say that oral intake. The non-carcinogenic risk through the drinking water pathway is term of CDI. CDI means chronic daily intake. How much chronic daily intake is calculated by following formula, which was invented by the US Environmental Protection Agency. Here, this formula, I will try to give all the information that will really helpful to you to publish your article in reputed journals if we implement this method. But please note that if you find out higher concentration of the fluoride, nitrate, arsenic, other toxic elements, then you can implement. Otherwise, there is no use for this implementation of the human health risk assessment. Here, CPW means the concentration of concentration of particular contaminant in groundwater, for example fluoride or nitrate or arsenic or something. And IR is indicates the human ingestion rate liter per 2.5 mg per liter, 2.5 liter in a day adult, 0.78 liter for children. Where did I collect this data? This data was published in United State Environmental Protection Agency has published a approximate data. But this is a country to country, it will change. Country to country, it will change. And it is a whether we are in a summer season or winter season, that is also change. That is also changes. But United Environmental Protection Agency has given some guidelines. We can follow that and implement we can follow the regulations from the United State Environmental Protection Agency in order to implement the health risk assessment. ED is the exposure duration, 64 years, 77 years, 12 years for regarding men, women, children respectively. And EFE indicates for the exposure frequency, 365 days or something. All this information is available in the website. Website published there, United States Environmental Protection Agency is published several notes. When we go to that note, then we may understand the how do we take exposure frequency and human ingestion rate and body weight also. Body weight here ABW is indicates the average body weight. Here I gave this information 65, 55, 15 for male, female, women, children respectively. Average time. When we conduct this 365 days into age, and then it comes automatically. If we multiply 365 days into 67 years, then this equation comes like that. Dermatal contact in order to assess the health risk for exposure, dermatal contact pathway is also this equation designed by the US EPA. Here DAD indicates that dermatal absorbed dose, and TC indicates that indicates the contact duration, and 0.4 hours per day for adults and children. KI indicates the dermatal absorption parameters, 0.001 centimeters per hours. EV indicates bathing frequency times a day, considered as one time in a day. Suppose when we are in summer season, we take bath in twice in a day, two times in a day. Then we can choose whether it is one time or two time. That is in which season we are in. SSA is a skin surface area available for contact. Here this 16,600 square centimeters is adopted, is taken from the US EPA guidelines, and EF is a conversion factor, 0.01. ED is the exposure duration, 64, 67, 12 for males and women, children respectively. EF is exposure frequency, 365 days, and body weight also, as we discussed in drinking water pathway, body weight and average time is similar in dermatal contact and oral intake pathway. And once we calculate the dermatal contact and oral intake pathway, then we can find out the when we input the CDI value in this equation, then we can get the sum values, and HQ hazard in hazard quotient oral and dermatal pathway, and RFD represents reference dose of specific contaminant. Generally, nitrate nitrogen 0.1.6, and if we take a fluoride, the 0.6. It is also available in the United States Environmental Protection Agency. Then, when we complete the analysis procedure, calculation procedure, we reach a final stage. Here, we find out the total hazard index. And please add the oral intake pathway and detrimental pathway. Then we can get the total hazard index. That is called as a human health risk assessment. If we find out the this total value less than one, there is no health risk for the people. And if you find out the higher value of total hazard index is higher than one, it indicates that non-carcinogenic risk is existed in our study. Therefore, it is better to estimate the by using proper existing values. Please note that the all values should be taken by the United Protection Agency US EPA website. All values are available in the website. Please go through the website and collect the sufficient information and implement your health risk assessment data, health risk assessment calculation. And in addition to that, several articles were published in various journals. Please go to that website and go to that article. You may understand clearly and implement this method in your study region. This once we complete the calculation part, you can generate the distribution map of the children's men, women, and infants also. This is the distribution map of the study area. This generated by me by using Surfer software. And here is indicates the less than one is indicated into the green color, and yellow color indicates 1 to 2, red color indicates the more than two, and yellow and red color is indicates that these kind of regions, those who live in these regions have higher health risk due to intake of contamination drinking water. And in addition to that, this is the women percentage. Less than one is a less than one, 1 to 2, and above two. And this you can also classify in this way. And children's also similar way. But once we input the data in our distribution pattern, that will really help us to know in which area we can get higher concentration in this region. But this is another data that is published in Ecotoxicology Environmental Safety Journal. You can go to that published an article in this generated this data diagram is generated by me. And if you implement, please note that if we implement human health risk assessment, children and infants have more chances to get ill health, because lower body weight and consumption exposure of the contamination is more high than the men and women. So if you find out any region, you can classify male, female, children and infants, the concentration increases like this, and men and female and women, male, female, children and infants. You can add also another part here, and then you can generate the distribution map of the each health risk assessment for total hazard index for male. In this region, the green color indicates that there is no health risk in this particular region, and orange and blue, orange color and other color indicates the there is a greater chance to those who live in this region have greater chance to expose the health risk by drink, by intake and dermatal contact pathway. Similar way we can use by using different methods. So far I have I tried my best to explain the physicochemical parameters in a simple way, and this is please note that the when those who are in the initial stage, this presentation will be helpful for them to conduct and to conduct the research program for pursuing PhD and master's thesis and publishing article, publishing their article. In those who are in initial stage, this will be, I hope this presentation will helpful for them. But those who are in higher category have great knowledge, I hope this presentation may not helpful for them, because I have given only basic information. But Sahu Parpula K. Sahu explained greatly, but I designed this presentation for in view presentation in view of those who are in a initial stage to conduct the research program.